Stop scratching your head. You have options to display the coolant temperature of your GM LS engine in a Dakota Digital instrument system. Our BIM-01-2 plugs into the OBD2 diagnostic port to pull temperature data, or you can wire the instruments directly. This quick video covers the proper installation of the included water temperature sender. The brass temp sender supplied with every Dakota Digital kit features 1/8 NPT threads and is accompanied by a selection of brass adapter bushings. LS series cylinder heads typically require a 12 by 1.5mm thread and crush washer. Before you even open the hood, thread the sender into the 12mm bushing by hand several times. Think of the sender as a tap and you're chasing the threads in the bushing. A few minutes spent here can save headaches later by ensuring the new brass components fit together without issue when you install them into the head. Separate the parts and set them aside. When scouting a location for the new temperature sender, remember that the OEM sender in the driver's side head is communicating with the ECM and needs to be retained, making the passenger side head's rear port a good choice. Using an 8mm Allen wrench, remove the factory plug from the passenger side head and make sure that the threads are clean. Place the aluminum crush washer over the bushing and thread the assembly into the head until the crush washer contacts the head. Grab your 5/8 wrench and snug the bushing against the washer. You may only get a quarter turn here, so don't go overboard. Next, thread the sender into the bushing. Hold the bushing in place and tighten the sender using your 3/4-inch tool of choice. Keep in mind the sender's 1/8-inch pipe threads are tapered, so the more you turn, the tighter it gets. The tapered threads do a great job of sealing, and additional sealing steps are usually not required. Don't get carried away tightening things in this step. It doesn't take much torque to properly seat these brass components. Ensure the socket is square on the sender and not applying any sideways pressure. Once the hard parts are installed, top off your cooling system and plug in the supplied weather-tight harness and move on to the next step of the installation.